he do it for me, he will do it for you. Is that good? Is that good? If he did it for me, I'm a witness that he will do it for you. Somebody ought to get excited about what God can do. I don't know what you're waiting on, but God is more than able. He's able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above. We can ask or think according to the power that works on the inside. Oh, beyond that, I'm about to seek glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Come on, bless his name. Father, we thank you. 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 Keep that playing just right underneath me a little bit. Oh God, we give you praise. 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 We magnify you. We glorify you. We bless your name because you're good. You're good. You're worthy to be praised. And we praise you, we magnify you, we glorify you in this place. Oh, glory to God, 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 oh, glory to God, bless his name. Bless his name. I wish somebody could help me praise him. Oh, we give you praise. Hallelujah, we give you praise. We give you praise, we give you praise. We give you the praise, we give you the praise. We give you the praise for you alone are worthy to be praised, and we praise you. Oh, bless his name. 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 God is good all the time. And all the time, God is good. Amen. What's so exciting about God is that he is good regardless. Amen. I said God is good regardless to whether or not you believe that he is good. Amen. It does not matter what you believe. God is good. I can't hear nobody. Amen. God is good to you when you don't even know it. Amen. While you're slumbering and sleep, God is good. He watches for you. He protects you from dangers seen and unseen. He's good. Somebody ought to say God is good. God is good, 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 he's good. Is there anybody in the house who God's been good to? Is there anybody in the house that God worked a miracle for? Huh? Is there anybody in the house that God healed? Huh? Hallelujah. Is there anybody in the house that God saved, that God delivered, that God set free? Oh God, and am I in the building by myself, or am I here with people who know that God is good? He's good all the time. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor beside you, I don't know what you're going through, but God is good. Hallelujah. All the time, and all the time, God is good. Oh my God. 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 He's good. He's worthy to be praised. He's an awesome God. He's an awesome God. He's an awesome God. Hando Obiasha. He's an awesome God. He's awesome. Yes, he is. I don't care. Hallelujah. I don't care what you think about God. He's awesome. He's amazing. He's wonderful. Ah, glory to God. Oh, I wish you could fall in love with the God that I serve. He's good. He's good. Oh, my God. He's better to us. He's better to us than we meant to him. I can't hear nobody. Yeah, see, he's the friend that will never leave you nor forsake you. Amen. You can kick God to the curb. He said, Lord, I'm with you always. I can't hear nobody. You can diss God, talk about God. You can put God on the shelf or put him on your mantle. But when you leave the door, he's with you always. I can't hear nobody. Yes, he'll go with you through hard trials. He'll go with you. He'll be with you. Man, I don't care. If you make your bed in heaven, he's there. If you make your bed in hell, God is there. Wherever you go, he said, I'll be with you. I'm talking about a good God. He's a good God. Yes, he is. He's no respecter of person. Yeah, he's not judgmental and critical and condescending. You don't have to do him a favor. It's not tit for tat. If you do it for me, then I'll do it for you, God. Well, the Bible says that while we were yet in sin, I can't hear nobody. While we were yet in sin, the Bible said he died. Before we even realized we needed a Savior, he settled our account. That's a good God. Hallelujah. That's a good God. I wish somebody would get excited about the God we serve. He's good. Look at your neighbor, tell your neighbor, we serve a good God. Come on, say it like you mean it. We serve a good God. Sebastian, we serve a good God. Yes, we serve a good God, and he's worthy to be praised. Somebody ought to clap their hands right quick. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to a good God. He's faithful. He's faithful. He's faithful. He's faithful. He's a good God. He's able to do exceedingly abundantly above what we can ask or think. Amen. I know we're living in a day and an hour where men's faith has grown cold. Amen. We don't believe God like we used to. Say amen.
Amen.
We don't trust God. Huh? We don't. We don't love him like we really should. We don't trust him like we should. We don't hope in him like we should. We don't depend on him like we should. We don't rely on him like we should. We don't follow after him like we should. We don't lean on him like we should. Hey, hallelujah, we don't. But we serve a God who is able. And that's exciting. He's not an idol God. He's not the kind of God you have to set up every morning. He's not the kind of God that you have to blow up every morning. Yeah, he's not the kind of God that you have to breathe life into him in order for her to have life. Yeah, he's not a God that you have to assemble. Yes, he's not a God that won't move unless you move him, or it, or this, or that. But he's a true and living God. And he's worthy to be praised. Is that right? He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be praised. God, I thank you for your faithfulness. 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 God, I thank you. Thank you. I'm toiling with the message for today. I know we're doing a series entitled The Exchange. I'm trying to get a sense of what God wants to say here in this place today. Amen. God is good. Amen. Come on, clap your hands and give God some praise. Well, come on, clap your hands and give God some praise. I'll get into it. Today we're going to talk about briefly, we're going to continue the message of the exchange. Amen. God shared with us at the beginning of the year that this year, it's a critical year. It's important that we understand what God is doing now. Amen. How many of you want to be in the middle of what God is doing?
Oh, yes. Yes.
How many of you all want to be locked in to what God is doing?
Yes. Yeah.
Have you ever been in the wrong place at the right time?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Or the wrong place at the wrong time, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. Or you missed it just by a...
Yeah.
You know, you second-guessed to yourself. You thought about it too long, and when you got there, it was over for
you.
You procrastinated, and you second-guessed. Not only that, then you got the opinions of others.
And
you checked with them to see if it was something they thought you ought to do. As it related to your life. Consulted other people to see if what you wanted to do was what they thought you should do. Now, how crazy does that sound? And because of that, we miss opportunities, huh? We're in the wrong place at the wrong time. Mm-hmm. Yes, but I'm sure if you're anything like who I think you are, you want to be in the middle of what God is doing. Am I by myself? You want to be in the mix. How many of you all like to be in the mix? Hey, man, I'm looking at people who you look like. You look like you like to be in the middle of stuff. Amen. 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 Minister Designate Smith, you look like you like to be in the middle of the stuff. You don't want to come in late. You want to be in the center of what's going on. Amen. Sister Donna, I know who you are, girl. I know you want to be right up in the middle. Look, you're the kind of person you'll get it started if it hadn't started already. Amen. I know you will. Yes, want to be in the middle of it. Amen. Delaney, want to be in the middle of it. Larry, want to be in the middle. Sebastian, you want to be in the middle of it. Is that right? Well, wouldn't it be awesome? You're talking about inside information. People make a lot of money when they have inside information. Those who knew the stock was going to fall got out before it fell. Because they had what inside information. And the rest of us who were clueless fell off the cliff. Amen. Praise God. Some of us are still falling and losing. Amen. Praise God. But how much more would it be if you're in the middle of knowing what God is doing? Is that anybody I'm talking to? I mean, can you imagine the advantage you have over those who are not in the middle of what God is doing, huh? How much further along will you be if you're in the middle, ahead of the pack? As it relates to what God is doing. Did you hear me? As it relates to what God is doing, I'm not talking about what the devil is doing. I'm not talking about what the president is doing. I'm not talking about what the city officials are doing. I'm not talking about what your friends are doing. I'm not talking about what your family members are doing. I'm not even talking about what's going on your job, in your workplace. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about being in the middle of what God is doing. Is that you? Do you want to be in the middle of what God is doing?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, I think somebody who has expanded this universe 13 billion light years and growing and expanding, I think that person, that mind has a little more insight than the rest of us. Wouldn't you think so? I don't know about you, but I would want my ear to his mouth. I would want to hear what she's saying. Amen. Because she got something to say. Have I got a witness? Yeah, we listen to a whole lot of chatting. We listen and lend our ears to a whole lot of stuff. A whole lot of junk. A whole lot of nothing that won't measure up to be anything but nothingness. And yet we have an opportunity to lend our ear to what God is saying. How much better would that be? You talking about inside information. That is awesomeness. Is that right? Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, that's awesome. I don't know about you, but I'm getting excited already. I'm getting excited. I feel the breakthrough already. Is that right? I feel my miracle happening already. Is that all right? I feel something stirring down on the inside. Is that right? Yes. So God spoke to me the first of the year, Elaine, and he said, the exchange. And I thought about that. I said, what are you saying? Because in 2016, he said, it is time. And in 2017, he said, go the distance. And in 2018, he said, the exchange. And as I began to ponder and as I began to think about it, I begin to see that it is like seed time and harvest time. That before you can reap a harvest, you have to sow a seed. And in exchange for what you've sown, God will grow it. But I hope you can see the picture. He takes what you give and multiplies that. So then the question is, what are you giving to God for him to multiply? What are you
What are you? So the exchange is really God giving back to you what you gave to Him.
Come on, say that.
Yeah. It's not a mystery. It's not. I hear you, God. It's not a mystery. It's not mystical. It's not beyond perception. He simply takes what you gave Him and gives it back to you, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. Huh? Yeah, so that's why you have to be careful how you sow. You have to be mindful. You have to be conscious how you sow. You've got to be conscious of what you sow. And you've got to know when to sow.
I'm preaching real good.
You gotta know. You gotta think. Amen. You gotta use your mind. Amen. You've got to think for yourself. Because only you know what you need back. Only you know what you need back. The Bible says that He's given everybody the measure of faith. And it's, I believe, I can say it's the size of a mustard seed. And He said, if you can take that mustard seed, faith, and move mountains. That's amazing, man. See, your problem is you ain't on God to move mountains. He said, I gave you a mustard seed. God, I need you to move this burden off me. But He said, but I gave you a measure of faith. But God, I need you to work it out because I can't do it. But I gave you a seed. See, we don't understand why. We don't understand that the seed is the vehicle God uses to give us classified information. Yeah. The code, the schematics, the details of what is to be is hidden in a seed. And He said, if you just sow it, woo, I'll grow it.
My God, that's right.
And what's in the seed is everything you need. I'm preaching real good. That's what you've got to be willing to give first. Mm-hmm. You've got to give first. You got to give first, and that's the problem. We want to see it first. Say amen.
Amen.
You want to see it first. I ain't going to do it till I see it. You got to show me the money. But if you apply the principles, the money will stop. Will not stop coming. If you do the principle, money will come. Money will be everywhere. I hope y'all caught that. Well, bless it. It will come from everywhere. Somebody say everywhere.
Everywhere.
It will come from everywhere. Money will come from everywhere. The Bible says money answered all things. You've got to get in. What's happening? It's time to give. It's time to engage in the exchange. Because what's going to happen, I promise you, this year, if you take this year seriously and sow and give, 2018, 2019, 2020, oh my God. It's going to be awesome. I don't know, but I'm getting excited right now about 20. I'm not going to wait till 2018, 2019. I'm excited about what God is going to do in 20. I'm excited. I'm elated because I know the principles of God. And He said, if you sow it, I'll grow it.
All right.
Yeah, who's ready to sow? Who's ready to engage? See, God is saying it's time for you to engage. And if you do so, the harvest is going to be, oh my God. Let me ask you, who needs a harvest? That might be the problem. Who needs a harvest? Who needs a harvest? Okay, maybe that's the wrong word. Who wants a harvest? Okay, who can use a harvest? Who's ever had a harvest before and would like to experience a harvest? Okay, who's had a harvest and want to experience one again? Okay, yeah, there you go. Okay. My harvest was nice, but I'm expecting God for more. Is that you? Yeah. Yeah, he did. He did some wonderful things for me last year, year before last, 5 years ago, 10 years ago. I remember when I had it good. I was rolling, baby. You couldn't touch me. You couldn't touch me. You didn't even recognize me. It was so good. But oh my God, you know what? I need another harvest. I need another miracle. I need another increase. I need to bump it up some more. I'm telling you right now, this is the season. Listen, I don't care what your harvest was last year. I don't care what it was. I don't care if it was one tomato or one tomato plant. And that one tomato was a cherry, itty bitty small tomato. Hallelujah. I don't care what it looked like. I'm telling you what God is saying. This is the year of exchange.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. My God.
It's the year of change. Yes. It's the year of exchange. It's time to put it in so it can come back out. Yes, he said, if you sow it, I'll grow it. You see, here's the thing. You have to have a mental picture of what tomorrow is going to look like right now. Yeah, you better see your tomorrow today, or your today will look like your tomorrow. Amen. Your tomorrow will look exactly like your today. You better vision and visualize what it's going to look like in 2 years, 5 years, 20 years from now. You better get excited right now about where you're going. Sister Donna, you better get excited. And oh my God, yeah, it was a mess back there, but I can see something different. My eyes have been changed, and then a miracle has happened. I was blind, once was blind, but now I see, and what I see is something awesome. It's amazing. It's wonderful. Oh my God, you don't see it. That's your problem. I see it. I see the best that God has. I see the miracles of God. I see healing in my future. I see a relationship in my future. I can't hear nobody. Yes, don't fool with me right now. Yeah, I know you're crazy. You can't see it right now because you're walking by sight. But I'm walking by faith. I'm walking by what I can imagine in my mind.
All right.
Huh? And because of what I see, I sow.
Yeah.
It's because of what I see, I sow. See, if you keep looking at what you see, you won't sow.
Right.
If you observe the wind, you won't sow. If you observe the weather, you won't sow. If you look at your bank account, you won't sow. Amen. You say, I've got to wait for something to get in there. But baby, you have to put something in there in order for you to, but you got to get first. The exchange. What are you going to give? Watch this. When are you going to give? What are you waiting for? You're waiting. See, we wait for things to be perfect. We wait for things, the planets to line up. We wait for our situation to improve. Well, that's how you get your situation to improve. We wait for it to be perfect and wonderful. But you better start giving now. Watch this. You better start being who you gonna be in 20 years right now. Uh-huh, you better be that blessing right now. You better be that miracle happening right now. Amen. What's wrong with you? Amen. What's wrong with you? You better be that blessing right now. Amen. Oh, bless his name. You better be it right now. You better be healed right now. You better be healed right now. You better be all that you can be right now. Because tomorrow is not promised. Yes. I'm that right now. I don't need the money in my pocket. That's what's wrong with us. See, you don't understand that your attitude and your disposition will attract money and things. You waiting on money. Money is waiting on you.
Yeah.
Money is in the balance, waiting on you to get right, church. She in the wing, right? Yeah, money sees you. Opportunity sees you. But see, with opportunity come a whole lot of stuff. An opportunity, that girl is something else. Who? She's a ditty, honey. She's regal and dignified, and she's reserved, honey. She has a little piety going on, honey. But when she come back, and oh my God. Listen, she ain't just coming. Bless his name. She ain't gonna just come, man. You got to stroke her back. You got to treat her right. You got to do her right. Cause when she comes, she comes fierce.
Bless his name.
It's when she comes, she gonna change your life. Amen. She gonna change your zip code and cause you to drive something differently. Amen. Oh, but baby, you got to show her right. You got to treat her right. You got to let her know that you want her. You gotta do it now. She waiting on you. Opportunity is waiting on you. But here's the thing about opportunity. Now somebody else might start courting her.
Come on, Bishop.
If she's an opportunist, praise God. Amen. She will go with those who treat her well. Amen. She is true to no one. And she's only true to the one who treats her well. But if you get her, amen. Amen. She'll never leave you nor forsake you. She'll be with you always. Even and she'll bring all her stuff with her. Bless his name. It's time now to get in the game. It's time now to make up your mind. Amen. That this is the year. Somebody say, this is the year.
This is the year.
This is the year I give like I've never given before.
Yes,
I know you gave. I know I did too. Been giving and tired of giving. Amen. Have you got a long time to give? You giving out. Amen. And you about done giving. Praise God.
Amen.
That's when you really give. Because that means you're right there. You're 3 feet short of your goal. It's usually right when you get ready to give up. It's just before you had enough. I'm done with this. I'm done. I'm tired. I'm not going to give not another nothing. Amen. And when you decide to give that time, amen, the doors will fling open. And you'll be so glad that you gave. I can't hear nobody. I can't hear nobody. I can't hear nobody. I can't hear nobody. I just can't hear nobody. Amen. And you think because you're tired and weary that it's time to give up a baby, that's time for you to shift gear and burn some fumes. Amen. Because that's about all I got is fumes. I ain't got no nothing else. I just got fumes. I've got the memory of what was. That's all I have. I don't see anything. I'm a little weary. Amen. I'm a little distracted. I'm stressed out and I'm confused and I'm tired and weary. I know he said don't be weary, but I'm weary. Amen. Bless his name. Tell the truth, shame the devil. I'm weary. I'm tired right now. I'm not tired right now. I'm not tired. I'm tired. Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. Amen. But it's in that moment when you can just press towards the mark, when you can just go through, when you can just keep going, when you can just. And hold on, the phone is ringing. It might be Jesus. Hello?
Stop it.
Huh? Yes. Absolutely. Tell them to just keep giving. You said, yes, sir. I love it. I will. Amen. God bless you. Somebody else bless his name. God, go ahead and clap your hands and give up. Amen. Yes. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. Yes. Amen. God told me to tell you, just keep on giving. Amen. Just keep on sowing. Amen. Just keep on doing. See, he may not come when you want to. Hey, but he's right. He'll call you up and tell you. He will call you up when you lose respect. Yes, he will. He'll call you on the telephone. Yes, he will. He'll call you on the telephone and send you a personal message. Won't he do it? Won't he going. Don't you quit. Don't you stop. The best is yet to come. The best of your life is in front of you. The best of what God has for you is in front of you. The best of what God has is right at your door. It's right at the door. It's at the door. It's at the door, darling. It's at the door, baby. It's hard. Smell it. I can sense it. I can see it. I can feel it. I know it's happening right now. He just called me and told me to tell you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
That's it.
Thank you.
Woo!
That's it.
Yes. On your behalf while you slumbered and slept, God has been working on your behalf. He's been negotiating deals. He's been negotiating contracts and terms in the contract. He looked over it and said, that's not enough. He looked at it and said, I don't like the terms. He looked at it and said, that's not enough. He looked at it and said, it won't work. I want more. Give him more. Give him more. Give him more. Give him more. Add some of this and add some more of that. Yes, extend her life and give her good health. Then he looked at it again and said, it's still not enough. Hey, man, and he's made them go back to the drawing board because he has you in mind. I can't hear nobody.
Hallelujah.
But see, what's about to happen, and I'm saying this by the Spirit of God, what's about to happen, and you need to hear me. I hope you get ready. I hope you're ready. What's about to happen, God is about to close the deal. I'm going to say it one more time. Y'all don't know what. I said, in just a little while, God is about to close the deal. Somebody, okay, you don't get it. In a little while, God is about to close the deal. You don't get it. He's about to. I'm going to say it one more time. Maybe I can use a deeper voice. Maybe I. Oh, in just a little while, God is about to close the deal. Yeah, I read it. You don't even know what that means. I said, in a little while, God is about to close the deal. Come on, clap your hands and give God some praise. Listen, if I were you, if you didn't know what that meant, I would clap because it just sounds good. He's about to close the deal. I know what we are saying. He's about to close the deal. Hallelujah. He's about to bless you. Hallelujah. He's about to open doors and make ways. I don't know why. Somebody ought to get excited about that. I don't know about you, but he's about to close the deal. What you've been waiting for, God is about to release it. What you've been believing God for, he's about to release it. What you've been praying for, he's about to release it. What you've been hoping for, he's about to release it. What you've been waiting for, he's about to release it. Say yes. Say yes. Come on and clap your hands and say yes. God is about to turn it loose. He's about to turn your life around. You better get ready because God is about to do it. I wish I had somebody in here who would just get excited about what God is doing. He's about to turn it around. Yes, he's about to turn it around. My God, I'm telling you right now. I'm telling you right now. Man, you just keep doing what you do. You just keep showing up. God is about to turn. I'm sorry. Let me speak properly. God has turned your life around. Somebody ought to get excited about God turning her life around. And see, people are watching you. The ones who are talking about you are watching. Two things, they're watching you. But most importantly, they're hoping you do not stop. Because your going is encouraging them. They don't have the intestinal fortitude yet to let you know. But in just a little while, they will follow you right here. I'm preaching real good. They're going to follow you into this place. They're going to come see what changed your life. Because they know you. But they're going to see the blessings of the Lord on you. Yeah. God going to use your life to show people that God can do it. Because we live in a society where people don't believe that God can do it anymore. People will use your life and show the world that God is still God and that God is still able to work miracles. Somebody ought to get excited. I know what I'm talking about. I know what I'm talking about. So you just keep doing what you're doing. I'm telling you, you know what? They're going to talk about you, but on one hand, they're hoping you don't quit. They need you. Because what's happening is that you're building their faith. They're thinking about their lives right now. They're looking at you now, and they're looking at themselves. They're looking at their own lives. They're taking an accounting of their lives, and they're realizing that they're coming up this show. And they're looking at you and they say, my God, you know, maybe we ought to start doing what Sister Donna's doing. Because they're saying, God bless you. They're hearing it over the phone. They can look at you and tell. It's just a vibration in the air. I feel it. So all you have to do is just keep doing. I promise you, They're hoping you don't stop. Because if you can hang in there long enough, watch this, until their faith is built up enough to come. Hey, Sister Donna, you going to church today? Yeah, baby, I'm going. That's my church. That's my bishop. She laid hands on me and something happened. Is that right?
Yes, Lord.
And since I've been coming, the Lord has blessed my life. And they'll be able to tell it better than you. Do you think I can get a rush? My bishop would love to meet you. And watch him fall in here like soldiers. And they're going to be faithful. And they're going to be your congregation. They're going to be your people. That you bring to God. He has a purpose for your life. And I'm glad to be a part of it. Amen. Somebody ought to clap your hands and give God some praise. What are you going to do? See, I'm going to preach this all year. What are we going to do? Because I've got to make sure we are in alignment with what God is doing. You hear me? Put a smile on your face. You ought to get excited because you're in the middle of God's will. The safest place in the whole wide world is in the will of God. And you are in the will of God. Be not weary in well-doing. You shall reap if you don't quit. Don't quit. I don't care what you're going through. Don't quit. Hang in there. Let's band together and hold each other up. Let's pray for one another. Let's support one another. I got you. You got me. There's no reason why we can't make it together. But this is the year of exchange. Your words, your conversation, your deeds, your attitude, your disposition. Not one who's defeated, but of one who has the victory already. Am I talking to the victorious? Already have the victory, then you ought to shout hallelujah. Oh, come on, you can do better than that. If you already have the victory, that's why you ain't right. If you already have the victory, you want to shout, hallelujah! Oh, be a shout, I have the victory.
Hallelujah!
Ooh, be a shout, I have it right now. You may go home and your furniture is in the same place it was when you left, thank God. Hallelujah. But right now, you have the victory. Hallelujah. Yeah. I have the victory. And I'm glad about it. Father, we thank you for the season of sowing and giving. And the sooner we get it in the ground, the sooner the process will begin. So today we sow in faith, knowing, trusting and believing the process. We thank you right now for the increase in Jesus' name. Everyone said, thank God. Amen and amen. Come on, clap your hands. Stand on your feet and give God some praise. Oh, come on, bless his name. Come on and bless his name. Come on and bless his name. Come on and bless his name. God, we thank you for it right now. In the name that is above every name, we give you all the praise. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor, for you alone are worthy to be praised. Oh, come on and bless his name. Come on and bless his name.